Hey there, welcome everybody. Welcome back to our live violin lesson. So happy to see some known faces today. I'm just moving the camera a little bit to see some known faces, some people that have been joining yesterday. I think I also see some new people joining in. Tell me where you are from the comments, and if you have been joining the former live sessions, or if this is your first time joining a Violinspiration live session. Let me know. Meanwhile, I'm going to give you an A. For everybody that doesn't have a violin yet, get your violin right now. And you can check if your A has the same tone as my A. Over here is the A. Take a moment to tune your violin, get ready, take a cup of tea, whatever you need to feel motivated to practice. Meanwhile, we are waiting for some new people. Today we have a really exciting topic. We are going to talk about how to play faster on the violin. And I think that this is such a great thing to talk about, because so many of us struggle with playing pieces as fast as we want to play them. And in some way, it's always cool to be able to play faster, right? So I think it's an amazing topic and so important. And today we are going to discuss so many things that will be so helpful for you if you ever struggle to play faster. So let me know where you are from, if you've been joining before. Yeah, there was Hussein already joined the previous lesson, and Anya already joined for the third time. That is really great. I see a hello from London from Chris, Sujit. Lonnie says, oh, thank you so much, Lonnie. She says, thank you for all that you do. We love you. Love you too. Love you too. Thank you so much. Cindy from Alberta, Canada is joining us today. Bawan. So I'm so happy that all of you are here to practice the violin today. It's a new week, so it's so great to start a new week practicing right away on the first day of the week on Monday. So happy to see you over here. And for those that don't know me yet, I'm Julia. I'm the founder of Violinspiration, where I offer online violin lessons, and I'm also the author of the best-selling Amazon book, The Ultimate Songbook for Beginning Violinists. So I'm a violin teacher and I'm teaching online, and I see Sabina Austria. Wow, great that you're there. So happy that you're joining today. So happy that you still play the violin. And Pibon from Thailand is joining. Okay guys, we are going to get started with our lesson, because we need to practice, right? We cannot just talk. Okay, let's get started with our lesson. Today we are going to talk about playing fast. How do we learn to play fast on the violin, and which approaches can we take to learn to play a piece faster than we've done before? So get your violin right now, and we are going to first warm up a little bit our fingers to be able to play fast. So get your violin, and first I want you to just tap with your first finger on the violin. We have to warm up our fingers a little bit. We are going to the second finger, third, and try to warm up every single finger. I see there's not a lot of comments coming in. That's a good sign. That means you have your violin and that you're practicing. If you don't have your violin yet, make sure to get it right now. Get it out of the case as quickly as possible. You can still join, and it's going to benefit you so much if you practice the exercises right away with us. And after this lesson, I promise you will be playing a little bit faster. In every practice session, we learn something a little bit. And if you practice a lot, many little things will make a huge difference. So this will make a difference. If you practice with us right now, you can make such a big difference and learn to play faster. So be sure to get your fingers ready. And if you've warmed up your fingers, I'm going to show you the pattern we are going to work on today. One, two, three, four. Okay, Today we are going to work on this pattern. We are going to work on the A major aperto, and it's going to sound like this. So we are imagining that you want to learn this piece really quickly, and I think all of us had some pieces that we want to learn really quickly, and you can apply all the teachings, everything that I'm teaching you today, to every single piece that you've ever played that was that you felt like you were playing too slow. You can apply all these teachings to all your pieces. I see some new people coming in. If you just entered this room, make sure to get your violin and join us for practicing. It's going to be amazing. We are working on playing fast, and you can still join us today. And it will make a huge difference. Make sure to practice with us. It's so much more valuable than scrolling more through your Facebook feeds. I tell you, I know it from experience. So today we are working on the A major aperto. And we are playing that in a specific bowing pattern. Now, first, there might be some people that are like, what's an aperto, Julia? Enlighten me. I will enlighten you. An aperto is a chord. You might be saying, Julia, wait a second, I don't even know what a chord is. That's great. That's a great question. A chord are several notes that sound good together if you play them at the same time. So I'm going to show you a chord right now on my violin. This is a chord. And chords are also very well known from the guitar, because guitar players almost only play chords when they are playing and singing with the guitar. If you ever saw a guitar playing, they are playing chords all the time. They are playing several notes at the same time that sound good together. So that's a chord. An aperto is when you take every single note from the chord and you play them separately. So instead of playing them all at the same time, you play them separately. But if you were to play them all at the same time, they would sound really good together. And why we are practicing apertos today is actually because apertos are one of the most common patterns that you find in songs. In pop songs, in film music, in pop music, and in classical music. In every style of music, you will find apertos. They are a pattern that is... It is just used in so many songs because there's like a few notes that sound good together, and so often songs use apertos to make the song sound good. So there's so many songs that consist at least partly out of apertos, and that's why we are practicing them today, because if we are able to play some apertos quickly, we are able to play a lot of songs at the same time quickly. So we are practicing many songs at the same time. Does that make sense? Because we're practicing a pattern that that emerges in so many songs that we practice it for that song and for the next song and for the song afterwards, because the pattern is in all these songs. It makes more sense probably if I would show you the sheet music. But I see some new people coming in. You can still join. Today we are playing about, we are practicing playing faster. Feel free to join us, get your violin right now. Don't scroll through Facebook anymore. Be sure to practice with us. Practice, you need to practice. Okay, aperto. So that's why we are working on aperto today, on this aperto, because it is a very common aperto and it emerges in so many songs, from beginner till more advanced songs. And you will really benefit from learning this specific aperto, learning this aperto to play this aperto fast, because as I said. So right now, I'm going to show what the notes of the aperto is. So the first note is, I'm going to write it down two separate ways. I'm going to make it bigger. It will be more visible for everybody. A0 is the first note. This will be just the open A string. Then we have A2. That's the second finger on the A string, also called the C sharp. Then we are playing the E string, open E string, E0, E, and then we are playing E3, the third finger on the E string, which is an A. Okay, we are playing that back and forth. So we are playing D. So we are playing A, C sharp, E, A. Let's just start with playing, the first part of the song. So that's what we are practicing. A, 2, E, 3, E, 2, A. That is what we are practicing today. Right now, try to play this on the violin yourself. And welcome for every new player. Right now, get your violin and play this on your violin. We are playing the A major arpeggio. A, 2, E, 3, E, 2, A. Try to play all these notes on your violin right now. I'm going to write it down a little bit more easily because I think it's a little bit difficult if you have to think yourself backwards, to think all the notes backwards yourself. So I'm going to write it down so like this. A0, A2, E, and then comes E3, E0, A2, and A. Okay, so we're working on this arpeggio. You want to learn this arpeggio fast. Now, there's something special about this arpeggio that we are going to learn faster. It has a special bowing pattern. It doesn't only have these notes, A, D, 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 D. It also has a bowing pattern that goes like this. These notes, A0 until E, are all on one bow stroke. They are slurred together, as we call it. And all of these notes are also in one bow stroke. Let's have a look at that. You are going to practice this right away, right now, right? So get your violin. When I'm talking, just keep practicing all the time. Keep practicing this pattern that you see here. Okay, so A, 2, E. A, 2, E. Let's try it again. A, 2, E. Again. First line. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now we are going to play the second part. 3, E, 2. 3, 3, E, 2. Again, up bow. We start with an up bow here. 3, E, 2. Again, 3, E, 2. E3, E0, E2. Again, 3, E, 2. And play it a few times more for yourself right now. I'm making it too difficult, said Bowen. I'm so sorry. Tell me if you have any questions or if anything is not clear. Just let me know. If I'm going too quickly, let me know. It's a little bit challenging, this. A to E. This will all be down bow. And this will all be an up bow. For those who don't know yet what up and down bow is, down bow goes downwards in this direction. And up bow goes in this direction. So up towards the sky with your hands is an up bow. Down towards the floor is down bow. Down bow, up bow. Okay, let's play it again. We start with the down bow. A, 2, E. And then we are playing 3, E, 2. Now there's one note left that we didn't play yet, and that is the A2. The A0, the open A string. So A0 is open A string. Let's play the open A string. We are just going to play that as a down bow. That's kind of doable, right? Open A string. Okay, let's play it all the way from here until here. A, C sharp, E, 3, E, C sharp, A. Okay, play it a few more times for yourself. Okay. So right now, A, we are first playing an A. Then we are playing a C sharp. Then we are playing an open E string. Then we are going to play the third finger on the E string, which is an A. Then we are playing the E string, just the open A, E string. There we are playing the A2, which is the C sharp, the second finger on the A string. And then we are playing the open A string. Open A string, C sharp, E, A, E, C sharp, A. For those who prefer to work with notes. Okay. Okay, I'm going to add the note names because you are asking for that in the comments. So this will be the A, A, C sharp. Then we have the E over here. The A over here, E over here, C sharp, and A. A, C sharp, E, A, E, C sharp, A. Now, if this didn't work, that is actually a good sign, because that is actually going to be a perfect demonstration for you, how you can practice a difficult piece like this. How are you able to play this correctly? Even though it is so difficult, it is so frustrating to learn it. Maybe it is not for you, and that is great. And then we are just going to learn about how to play this faster. But we are using this pattern not only because it is a really useful pattern, but also because it is a little bit difficult and it is hard to play it quickly. And you really need to practice this. Keep practicing. I'm going to show you right now the steps you can take to break a pattern like this down and to be able to learn to play this quicker and really reliable too. So not kind of like, you know, it needs to sound really proper and right. And I'm going to show you the steps you need to take if you have a difficult passage. You can apply these steps that I'm going to show right now. You can apply them to any song you are practicing. So if you have troubles playing it fast, these are the steps you need to take. I want you to take a pen and paper right now so you can write the steps down with me. So get a pen and paper. I will give you a moment. For those who already have a pen and paper, let's practice it for one more time together. A, two, E3A. 1, 2, 3. A, C sharp, E, A, E, C sharp, A. Okay. Does everybody has a pen and paper? Okay, step one. So we have a difficult pattern over here. The first thing you need to do, if you want to learn to play a pattern faster, step one, is to remove all dynamics. With dynamics, I mean playing loud, accents, any kind of special things that are added to the notes. For instance, in this part, it could be that the first note is an accent. Accent. If there's any accents in the piece, remove them. If there's any dynamics, if there's forte or piano or anything, crescendo, decrescendo, which means playing softer and playing louder and getting softer and getting louder. Remove all the dynamics. Don't worry at all about them. Just focus on the notes. Okay, that is step number one. Remove every special sign, dynamic, whatever. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Second step is to remove all bowing patterns. Second step is to remove all the bowing patterns. Often in pieces you see, oh, those notes should be slurred together. These notes should be played in this specific bowing way. Don't worry at all about the bowing. Don't just remove all bowings from the piece you want to learn to play faster. So the first step was remove dynamics. Second step, remove all the bowings. So in this case, we would first remove any accents. Now, there are no accents in this piece, but if there were to be, we are removing it. Now we are also removing the bowing. So we're not worrying at all about the bowing anymore. So don't care. We don't care about the up bows and down bows. So we are removing all the bowing. Okay, so now if you've removed all the bowings and all the dynamics, you just have a blank notes, just notes without any specific bowings. That is a great place to get started on the moment you want to learn to play faster. So first remove all the distractions so you can just focus on the notes. That's already difficult enough, right? And you already noticed just before, probably if you try to practice this with me, how confusing it was to add the bowing and add the notes and be like, oh my God, don't know where to start. Remove everything. You can use this technique in general. Now, only after you've removed everything, step three is practice to, that is the practice technique I'm going to show you. So playing faster practice technique. Okay, going to show you right now what I mean with it. So, I've seen some comments coming in meanwhile. Welcome to every new person that has joined right now. Some people are getting it. Great. Okay, so now we are working on playing faster. How do we go about playing faster? Now we've removed all the bowings, we've removed all the dynamics. Now we need to practice to play this song faster. Now there's several practice techniques you can use, but there's one that are particularly like, and that is metronome practice. So we are going to work on this piece with metronome practice right now. So first you take a metronome, and if you don't have a metronome yet, you can download them on your phone. You can just search for a metronome on the Google Play Store or App Store or whatever, and then you can download a metronome. So now I'm going to start a metronome, and you are going to start to play the piece at 50 BPM. You can choose 50. Right now I'm using the app Metronome Beats, and I just chose 50. Let's start. Okay. So now we're going to fix this piece in 50. So each of these notes is going to be one click. So on each click, we are going to play one note. One, two, play a long end. Did it work out? If this is still too fast, don't worry, you can still slow it down. Well, this practice technique is really, really going to help you if you have any fast passages. So really be sure to remember, use the metronome, remove all bowings, remove all dynamics, and then get the metronome. Start at 50, and we are trying to play it again. And with the metronome, try to play it yourself. Yes, you did it! Okay, great. Some people managed to play it right now, which is great. Again, one, one, two, three, four. Okay, so this is pretty doable, right? You are able to play it right now in this tempo, which is a great sign. Okay, now we cannot practice this as if we are playing it slowly, because our goal, our ultimate goal, is that we learn this fast. Now, if we play fast, we need to use some different techniques, and we are already going to integrate these techniques when we are playing slowly. The first thing, which is really important when you play fast, is that your hand and especially your forearm, so over here, are really relaxed. So now we are going to play it again, and you try to relax your hands, your fingers, your arm as much as you can without your arm just falling falling flat down. So still be able to play it. Okay, so we're playing it again, and relax your hand as much as you can. One, two, three, four. Did you feel a little difference in how your hand was more relaxed right now? That is great. Okay, try to relax your hand as much as you can, your arm. One place where you should also relax is your shoulder. Over here, make sure to relax your shoulders downwards, both of your shoulders. So now we are going to try it once more with very relaxed arm, shoulder, and hands. One, two, three, four. Did it work out? Great. Okay. Now the next step. We need to add an extra quality. So first we have to relax, because if we are playing fast, we cannot play fast without relaxing our hands. So relax as much as possible. Second thing you need to do when you practice it slowly is to make sure your fingers are really close to the fingerboard if you are not playing a note. So not if you are playing a note, of course you have to put it on the fingerboard, but the notes that you are not playing should be really close to the strings. I'm going to show you very closely. So if we play, do you see the difference between and? Of course, if you play it slowly, you will be able to play. You will be able to play it if your hands are far away from the fingerboard. But if you keep practicing it slowly and always keep your hands far away from the fingerboard, you can't do it quickly. Because if you are, if you want to play the song quickly, you really need to be able to place your fingers very close to the strings. So be sure to already, when you are practicing slowly, make sure your fingers are close to the strings so you are practicing to play it quick later on. Okay, now we are playing it again, two times behind each other, maybe even four times. Four times behind each other, we are playing the same structure again. And now you are taking care that you relax your hand as much as possible, your arm and your shoulder, and two, you are also making sure that your fingers are as close to the fingerboard as they can possibly be, the fingers that you are not playing, without getting confused. Without touching the strings. So make sure your fingers are as close as possible and make sure that your hand is as relaxed as possible. One, two, three, four. We're practicing slowly. These are the practicing slowly steps. Relax. Second step was move your fingers very close to the fingerboard, the fingers that you're not playing. Third step is put your fingers on the string really quickly. Drop them on the string really quickly. Okay, so instead of just like putting them on the string like push, push, you're like dropping them. Bam, bam. Bam. Can you try that? Just put them on the string right away when you want to play them. Okay, we are going to... there's also a question coming in if we should always start off At 50, it really depends on how well you already play a piece, and you should definitely not always play with a metronome, but for speed practice it really makes sense, and you start at a speed that is definitely doable for you and that is very easy. And in this case, 50 I thought was a good speed to get started on, because it is kind of, I think it will be doable for most of you. So yeah, it really depends on your situation with which speed you get started, but 50 is often a good starting point. So right now we are playing the piece once more with a relaxed hand and fingers and everything. We are relaxing, we are close to the fingerboards, and we are dropping our fingers quickly. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, four times just after each other. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, relax your hands. Drop your fingers quickly. Keep your fingers close to the fingerboards. Okay, that was great work, everybody. If this is still a little bit too fast for you, don't worry at all. That is completely normal if you have not been playing for a very long time, or just never have been practicing arpeggios before. This can be very well be that this is still fast, and in that case, keep it slower. Make sure to practice it slower right now while I am explaining more things. Just keep practicing all the time. Okay, right now I'm going to show how it could look like to kind of go a little quicker and bump the tempo up a little bit. So now we are going to try to play the same piece at 60 BPM, still with relaxing, keeping your fingers close to the fingerboard, and dropping your fingers quickly. Okay, we are playing it at 60 now. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Coming in, welcome Lee from Guatemala, and welcome Josie to the lesson. Okay, right now we are going to bump it up a little bit more again. Make sure to keep your hand relaxed, and if your hand starts feeling really stressed, make sure to go slower again. This is just what it could look like, but often it is, you need to practice many practice sessions to be able to make a big difference in speed. So you have to practice. On one practice session, maybe you go from 40 BPM to 60, and then another one you go from 60 to 70, and you try to make it a little bit faster each time you practice. So now we are going to 70. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again. Bump the speed up again. Make sure to practice just slower right now if this is too quick for you. I'm just going to show the range of speeds in which you can practice this exercise right now. 100. Let's try it. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Once more, we are going to, I'm going to bump it up quite a bit. I'm going to 150. For many of you, this will be too fast. I'm just kind of showing the scope of how fast you can become if you practice this more often. Okay, but you can try it right now. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, and I think you get the point, right? So now I'm going to 200, that will be the last speed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. And you could even go to, let's go to 300 right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, if you reach a very high tempo, and if you are happy with the tempo you reached with this metronome practice, you can start to add the bowing again and add the dynamics. So right now we are going to go back a little bit because this was probably much too fast for many of you. So we are going to back to 6, maybe a little bit faster, 70. We are going back to 70. And now we are going to try to add the bowing. So first we are going to play it again at 70. And if we are able to do so, we are going to add the bowing. Okay. Hey, great that one of you had an easy time at 300. So I challenge you to try it at 400, 500, and add the bowing at that tempo. That will be very difficult. 2, 3, 4. Okay, once more without the bowings. 1, 2, 3, 4. And again. Relax. Drop your fingers quickly. Keep your fingers close to the string. Okay, now we are going to add the bowing. I'm going to show the... Oh my God, one of you actually played vibrato just right now, which is great. Yesterday we've been working on vibrato. So if you want to work on vibrato, you can have a look at yesterday's lesson after this class. Okay, our bowings were the following. We first had a down bow, G, D, D, A, C sharp, E. That was all a down bow. And these three notes were all an up bow. So it was A, 2, E, and then 3, A, 2. So down bow, up bow. Let's try that right now. Once more. Okay. So try to practice this right now on your own violin. If you don't have a violin right now, make sure to get it, because it will be the best way to improve right now. And you will really notice a difference after this lesson. Each day that you practice makes a difference. So definitely get your violin if you don't have a violin right now. And we are going to continue. And welcome, Laura. So we are working on the A major virtual right now. So be sure to get your violin quickly and join in. So right now, we are going to add the bowing. So try it again. A, 2, E, 3, E, 2. Once more. A, 2, E, 3, E, 2. And now the A. So that will be a down bow. This will be an up bow. And then we are playing just an A. A, C sharp, E will be all on the down bow, all in this bow direction. And then A, E, C sharp will all be on the up bow in this bow direction. And then the A will again be a down bow. Okay, so once more. trade at 70 BPM. If you're not able to do it yet with the bowings, just join in without the bowings and at the bowings after the class and practice more by yourself. 1, 2, 3, 4. Class already, because we've been working on it. Let me know in the comments if it is working better right now for you. So so right now you could again try to speed it up with the metronome with the correct bowing. So now we could play it with this bowing at 100 BPM. So let's try it. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you're able to, make sure to play even faster. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So yes, right now we've been working on the A major arpeggio, but this practice technique, you can use it for any passages that you want to play slowly. quickly, of course. Okay, I'm going to show you right now what we've learned today, because there's some important takeaways that I want you to not forget after following this class. Okay, so the first thing that you need not to forget is one, is strip the piece. How could you say that in English? Remove all bowings and dynamics. So if you want to learn to play a piece quickly, make sure to remove all the special bowings and all the dynamics so you can just focus on the notes first. And the second thing I want you to take away from this class is that you have to relax your hands. And you already should be working on that if you are playing slowly. The third thing I want you to take away from the class is that you need to keep your fingers should be close to the fingerboard. Make sure that the fingers are close to the notes before you already play them, so you can put them on the string really quickly and they don't have to come from really far away. The fourth thing I want you to take away from the class is that you have to drop and lift fingers quickly. Hope this is readable. You have to drop and lift fingers quickly, even if you practice slowly. So this is a big mistake many people make, is that they're like, oh, I'm playing slowly anyway, so I can kind of, you know, relax. But really try to imagine that you are playing the piece really fast, and then you have to make sure your fingers are close to the places where you have to put them. You need to drop the fingers quickly, and you already need to do that when you're practicing slowly, so you can also apply all these things when you're practicing quickly. So the fifth thing that I wanted to take away is metronome practice. That is actually really useful, and that you need to download the metronome, and that you will really benefit from more metronome practice in your life if you struggle with playing quickly. So these are most important things. Remove all the bones and dynamics, relax your hands, fingers close to the fingerboard, drop and lift fingers quickly, and metronome practice. Now, you can just apply all these tips. I would recommend that if you practice a really long piece and you want to play the whole piece quickly, you need to take special bars out of the piece and just work on practicing them quickly first. I actually recommend to work with 8 until 16 notes at the same time. So 8 till 16 notes at the same time and not more than that. So if you want to play a whole piece quickly, work on one bar at a time, just a few notes at a time, so you can actually learn to play these notes really quickly And then if you are able to play these notes quickly, you move on to the next bar. Because otherwise you get this overwhelming, really big piece and you want to learn to play everything quickly. And you won't progress on anything, so you won't see results as quickly. If you are just working on one bar at a time, you will see results in that specific bar. And that will really motivate you to keep practicing with the metronome and keep getting faster in the other bars too. So that's what I really recommend if you're practicing longer pieces, because that is, of course, what we just practiced was a short piece. So that will be really useful for you. Okay, so I'm going to get to your questions in a second. I see there's some questions coming in. But before I get to the questions, I want to make a little announcement for the next class that is going to take place next week, so you can already put it in your calendar. So there's actually two classes. No, it's this week already. Oh my God, it's the new week already. Okay, so the next classes take place on Saturday and Sunday. Again, these are live classes, just like this class. But in this weekend, we are actually separating the group in two groups. One will be the beginner group and one will be the advanced group, because we are going to discuss some concepts that will be especially helpful for beginners and advanced people. So the beginner group will be for everybody that plays the violin below 1 year, or that plays the violin between 1 and maybe at most 3 years and feels like they didn't practice a lot in this time. So if you haven't practiced a lot, and if you are practicing more than a year, so maybe between 1 and 2 years, you can also join a beginner group. If you're practicing for more than 2 years, I actually recommend to join the intermediate group. So the beginner group will take place on Saturday, beginner, Saturday the 11th of November. And if you want to receive an update about when the class starts, definitely be sure to subscribe to my mailing list at violinspiration.com/free membership. violinspiration.com/free membership, because there you can get an update of all the live classes and everything that is happening on the site. So the beginner class will happen at the 11th of November, same time as today, 8 p.m. GMT plus one. It will be 8 in Germany, and I'm not sure in other countries. So intermediate class will take place on Sunday. So this Sunday will be the intermediate class. This Saturday will be the beginner class. And I can really recommend you to join there, because in these classes, I really put my heart and soul into it. I'm actually working on creating PDF files for every student that is joining the class. And I'm really putting a lot of effort in these classes, because I'm going to show you kind of step-by-step plan how to get from beginner to intermediate. And for the intermediate people, I'm going to give you a step-by-step plan to get from intermediate to an advanced player. And I really worked on this kind of these steps for myself and for my students, really like years actually right now. So yeah, I'm really trying to put it in a really good class. I really want to make this a really good class. So yeah, it will probably be really worth it to join the class. And right now I am going to show you, we are going to discuss the questions that you have. So if this exercise today was really easy for you, you will definitely belong in the intermediate class. And if this exercise was quite challenging today, you will probably benefit a lot from the beginner class. Okay, so right now I'm going to have a look at questions that you are asking. Thank you so much for all the kind comments, for Melinda and Monica. And okay, a good metronome app. Manisha asked for a good metronome app. Actually, the app that I like myself the most is called Stage Metronome. But it is very complicated. You see, it looks like this, very fancy. And actually for beginners, I would recommend another app, which is Metronome Beats, because it is easier and more straightforward for beginners. So if you are a beginner, I recommend Metronome Beats. And if you are advanced and want to have advanced functions or just like fancy apps. This is stage metronome. This is the one that I use for my practice. I like this one the most. Okay, I'm having trouble learning the 30 second notes at the moment. So actually, probably you're quite advanced already. So, but you can use the same practice techniques for advanced kind of pieces. Actually, I use these for advanced. Oh, they're not there anymore. But these exercise techniques that I showed in this class, you can also use them for very difficult pieces. And you can just try to speed it up and get faster all the time and try to relax your hand as much as you can and remove all the bowings that will be useful at any level, even if you are quite advanced. Thank you. Oh, Angel is going to join the intermediate class and Melinda the beginner class. That would be awesome to have you join. I will put so much time into preparing for you guys. I really appreciate you joining. The class won't take place on Facebook, by the way, this time on YouTube, because there are some people that don't have Facebook and they asked me to put the class on another platform. So I'm actually going to put it on YouTube probably, or on my own site, so people don't have to log into Facebook. Okay, one thing, I'm still struggling with hitting the neighboring strings when playing. Are there any exercises that will help for this? Kristin, you will definitely benefit so much from the beginner class, because actually I plan to talk about this specific subject. There are actually exercises you can do to improve this, and I will talk about it. So that's something. And also, there's somebody else that says me too. So yeah, you will also benefit from it. Laura says, I have trouble crossing strings without making wispy noises. That's actually the same trouble, right? Like string crossing, how to get really good at string crossing and not hitting neighboring strings and really be very secure on one string at the same time. That is actually what we will discuss in the beginner class. So definitely be sure to come to the beginner class. Anya says, thank you so much for your engagement. How do you say that in English? She says something in German. Thank you so much, Anya. I really appreciate that you've been practicing with us 3 times this week. I'm so happy to have you join us. I wrote down the wrong date. This will be the 10th of November. Thank you, Sujit, for mentioning. Beginner class will be the 10th, intermediate will be the 11th. So Saturday, the beginner class, Sunday, the intermediate class. Sign up for the website. There we'll share all the details. Sabine is going to join Voortgeschreven Groepen, the intermediate class. Thank you, Sabine. Actually, I lived in Trier too. That's amazing that you live in Trier. Marshmood says, I have a problem with fingers when I play a piece of music. The fourth finger looks wired. Yeah, actually, the fourth finger class, we had a fourth finger class 2 days ago. So you can actually still rewatch it. It doesn't have the best quality. It was the first class and there were some issues with the class quality. But still, the information is super useful and you will really benefit from the class if you have problems with the fourth finger. Thank you so much. Okay. Can you show the picture of the metronome beats again, please? Okay, I will show one more picture of metronome beats app. Metronome beats. This is on Android. I'm not sure what it would be like on if the same app is available. Metronome beats. This is what it looks like. So yeah, I think what is the best tuning for the strings? E, A, D, G. So just the regular tuning, I think, is the best tuning, in my opinion. Okay, so guys, thank you so much for joining me today. I'm so grateful that you have been here today and have practiced with me. So happy to have such motivated people and to meet all of you. Even though we didn't meet face to face, I feel kind of connected to you in a way because we have this little chat happening and it feels really amazing to communicating with you from all over the world. So thank you so much for joining our practice session today and for just kind of being so uplifting and motivating in the comments and encouraging each other to practice and also encouraging me as a teacher to teach, because it's so motivating to see your comments and to see all your positivity. This really motivates me to create these lessons. And it's an honor to be able to teach people from all over the world. So thank you so much for joining. Thank you, Cindy, Monica, Sabina, Angel, and Melinda, and Mahmoud, and Vasila, Chris, Kirsten, and yeah, everybody who has been joining today, Sabina, Sujit. Thank you so much for being there. And I really hope to see you on the next lesson. So either the beginner class on Saturday or at the intermediate class on Sunday. I would really love to see you there. More information on my email list, violinspiration.com/free-membership. There you can subscribe to the mailing list. And I really look forward to see you in the next class again. Thank you so much, James, Dan, for joining. And yeah, thank you so much for all the appreciation. And I hope to see you in the next live classes. They are all free, by the way. So I had some questions coming in about payments. So they are free. You can just join. Just make sure to subscribe to the website, because they won't take place on Facebook this time. For those that don't have Facebook, I have many subscribers that don't have Facebook, actually. So next classes will take place somewhere else, probably on YouTube. So you could subscribe to the YouTube channel. And yeah, see you later, everybody. Thank you. Goodbye.